Thank you, Pastor.
Morning!
Good morning, good morning.
Tingnan mo naman yung nasa kanan mo at nasa kaliwa mo, bulungan mo naman. Tanungin mo, bakit ang ganda-ganda mo ngayon? Eh, sumagot ka naman, sabihin mo, because I have Jesus in my heart. Sabihin mo, saktay mo, I have Jesus in my heart. Kala mo ah, takot ka, no? Baka utangan ka eh, kasi maganda ka daw. Welcome to our Power of One series, Power of One, because we live, we worship, and we acknowledge just one God, and His name is Jesus Christ. Amen? So there's power in one. Power of One, we started with, this is a real life discipleship series. We started with episode 1, Team Jesus, because we believe in the power of one. We belong to one Team Jesus. And if you look around, that is your Team Jesus, right? We work together, we minister together, and we will reach as many souls as we can. Power of one, as in until the day we die, we will say one more soul for Jesus. Sabihin mo sa katabi mo, one more soul for Jesus. In episode 2, we talked about the great invitation, that we are all product of an invitation, right? Jesus invites us to be disciples, and we will be inviting people to be disciples of Jesus. So, episode 3, we talked about being a fisherman, fishers of men. You are called by God to be fishers of men. Sabi natin, huwag tayong masatisfy na panoorin yung mga isda sa aquarium. Right? Siluin natin. Hulihin natin. Let's catch the fish. Huwag lang natin panoorin sa aquarium. Alright? In episode 4, we talked about how to grow as a disciple. Remember, from being a spiritually dead, you become a spiritual infant after you got born again. And then you become a spiritual child. And then you become a spiritual young adult. And then you become a spiritual parent, that you will make disciples, no, this time, para the generations of Christians will continue on and on and on. Imagine after Jesus ascended to heaven, and ang huling bilin niya, make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, no? Yun ang huling bilin niya, tapos ang ginawa ng apostles niya, disciples niya, natulog lang sa kangkungan, hindi tayo Christians ngayon. These disciples, these apostles made a dent in the universe that until now, 2021, we can feel, no, yung revolution na sinimulan ng Panginoon. And that is the spiritual revolution. Last week, we talked about episode 5, 3 keys to make disciple towards a successful journey. Sabi natin, in-identify natin yung first key, ikaw yon. Ikaw ang intentional leader. You are the driver. Sabi natin, ang second key, we need to create a relational environment. No? Kumbaga, safe yung disciple mo. Papakainin mo, di ba? Yesterday, we had fun. No? We invited all the basketball players to have lunch with us. Nothing more, nothing less. Hindi yung tipong sinisilo mo dahil meron kang gusto pang ibang agenda. It's just plainly showing the love of God, and we are friends. Diba? Wala naman, diba minsan, mas maganda yung pag inibita ka ng kaibigan mong kumain sa bahay nila dahil masaya siya na maging hospitable and gusto niya na makasama ka. Hindi yung after kang pakainin, open-minded ka ba? Meron kasi ako yung i-share sa iyo na ano eh, pagkakitaan natin to. Diba? So we create a relational environment where we promote friendship, the love of God, and discipleship. That's why we create the courtyard experience every Sunday, right? Because it's impossible for us to make disciples if we don't know each other. Ngayon, madami ka na bang kilala? Di ba? Madami ka na bang kaibigan? Yun, wag mo naman i-abuse, okay? Kasi we need to create a relational environment. Tapos sabi natin yung pangatlong susi, yun yung reproducible, no? Na imbaga nauulit, na re-reproduce yung sitwasyon, yung discipleship. And for this morning, ayan, ako na lang mag-ano. Tinuro ko ni Pastor Ward kanina. I-introduce ko ang isang ang ating special guest. May special guest tayo this morning. Manyari ako si Pastor Bert. Alright, so ang special guest natin this morning, no, ang maganda, naka-align siya sa ating campaign na discipleship, no. Actually, he came from she's coming from isang church na well known sa discipleship, no. Ang ating special guest for this morning ay sabi niya tatlong bagay lang kung paano siya introduce. Una, anak siya ni Tita Pe. Pangalawa, kapatid siya ni Stephen. Ang hirap ayan. At ang pangatlo, no, she finished biology and BS biology and MS ano, Master of Science in molecular biotechnology. Well, parang ako kasi tapos ako ng ano ng nuclear physics sa UP. No, ano pastime ko 'yon habang nabobore ako. No, obviously academically equipped tong bata na to. She's a professor ng biology sa UP Los Baños, no. At kumbaga with all those blessings na narisibo sa Panginoon, pero ang pinaka blessing na na-appreciate ko sa kanya is that she is a teacher not only of biology but a teacher of the word. Amen. She's a part of the music team ng Victory Los Baños and discipleship team ng Victory Los Baños. So let's pwede po ba tayong tumayo lahat? Let's give our best clap offering para sa Panginoon sa buhay ng ating kapatid na si Sister Faith Maranan, come here, Sister Faith. Maraming salamat sa pagpapaunlak mo sa amin. She'll be talking about the rewards of discipleship. This will be our episode 6. Thank you. You may please be seated. You want to use this? All right. Thank you. Naka-on siya?
Hello.
Yeah. Meron.
Thank you. Hello, good morning everyone! Tanggalin ko daw kung... So, good morning everyone! Again, I'm Faith. And I'm so happy to be here. Actually, hindi ko po talaga ina-expect na makakarating po ako. But I really thank the hand of the Lord who made this possible. Kasi alam niyo naman po sa tingin sa'yo na may ECU. So, it really, I would say a miracle.